by the day I met the perfect stranger. I think about us and I think about the day I got wrapped around your finger. I think about us. The sun was shining on you. The Lord was smiling on me. And love was calling us. I had my mind made up. And I can't stop loving you. I can't help myself. And I can't get over you. No matter what I tell myself, baby. Never thought I'd ever love anyone else. In my weakness, I think about us. And I think about the day you left without speaking. I think about us. I think about the love.
Feels like I'm losing control. I'll take your love. Catch me.
Gathered here today because Christians believe in Christian marriage. We believe that it's appropriate for Christians together to celebrate this happy occasion and to praise God for His goodness. Even more importantly, we believe that it's right to make our marriage vows to one another in the presence of God and His people. We cannot act alone, even if we so desire. Each of us is the result of the influences of family and friends, of many years of interactions with other people. And when we gather for Christian's wedding ceremony, we simply acknowledge that God and other people have touched and affected our lives in significant ways. The Bible is full of reminders that God established the home and that He gives His blessings to those who follow the simple guidelines that He has set forth. This is the good part. Darius, do you promise to live with Jasmine according to God's purposes? Do you promise to commit yourself to meeting her needs physically, emotional, and spiritual? And do you promise that whatever the circumstances, that you will love, honor, and sustain her, and that as long as you both shall live, you will be faithful to her? Do you so promise? I do. Jasmine, do you promise to live with Darius according to God's purposes? Do you promise to commit yourself to meeting his needs, physical, emotional, and spiritual? And do you promise that whatever the circumstances, you will love, honor, and sustain him, and that as long as you both shall live, you will be faithful to him? Do you so promise?
I do.
We up to the ring ceremony. A circle never ends, so Christian marriages should never end. They should last and last and last. Difficult times will come, but the commitment of Christians is to make their marriage to go on forever. The ring, which is a circle, is a reminder of a never-ending commitment. Also, rings are made out of precious metal, usually silver and gold, which has the unusual quality of getting better and more valuable with age. Instead of wearing out, and deteriorating, we pray for your love to grow and to improve with age. Darius, do you give this ring to Jasmine as a sign of your Christian commitment to her in marriage? Okay. And Jasmine, do you give this ring to Darius as a sign of your Christian commitment to him in marriage? All right, let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in their peace and continue in their favor through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now we're up to the good part, because we're getting ready to have the Unity Cross ceremony. If you notice that the cross is made up of a vertical relationship, and this tells us that we must experience God at home. We must ask him to be our Lord and Savior. And the Bible teaches us that if we accept God as our personal Savior, we have access to not only the Father, but we have access to the Holy Spirit. I was lost, but now I'm found. And I use God's holy cross as a bridge to come over the other side, that I can experience a new birth and a new walk with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Jasmine and Darius, since you have committed yourselves to a lifelong love before God and these witnesses, and since you have agreed to meet the needs of each other as long as you both shall live, and you have made your intentions public, acting in the authority vested in me by God and his church, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. You may now salute the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, they are no longer two, but they one. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jasmine Busby.